Is it okay to be late? Yes or no?
No?
No? Some people think it's okay? Why is everybody always late? Some people think it is okay to be late. I once had a Canadian friend in Taiwan when I first arrived. He said, you know what? If I tell you I'm going to meet you at 2 o'clock, I actually mean 2:15. If I say 2:30, I mean 2:45. What do you mean? Like when you say 2:30, be there at 2:30. In fact, in our modern culture, more and more people seem to accept the fact that it's okay to be late. A few years ago, my precious Iris gave me this book. It's a bestseller. It says, "Thank you for being late." Please don't. Please don't be late for me. When people are late for me, I have an incredibly terrible reaction. I first become impatient. I then become angry. I then become anxious. It's a weird reaction. It's not normal. But let me tell you why, my dear Toastmasters. See, once upon a time, this guy used to be about this high. When I was 10 years old, I used to go play tennis every Saturday morning with Mr. Sanders at the Eskom Tennis Club. Now, Mr. Sanders had played tennis in Wimbledon, first round only, got knocked out, not so good. But he was my tennis coach. And every Saturday morning at 9 o'clock, I would go to the juniors, beginners, tennis training. My mother would drive a car and drop me off. And I would stay there from 9 to 10, hitting that ball, practicing. 10 to 11 was the senior boys, and 11 to 12 were the advanced tennis players. And I would stick around, you know, maybe we could get a spare game. So my mother would drop me off at around 9 o'clock in the morning, and she would always be there at 12 o'clock to fetch me. One Saturday, she wasn't there. I waited. 5 minutes, some other parents said, "Can we take you home?" I said, "No, my mom will be here." 10 minutes, no mom. No other parents as well, all the kids are gone. 1 hour later, no mom. 1.5 hours later, no mom. So at about 10 years old, I decided I'll walk the 3 kilometers home. I finally get home. Didn't have a key. And remember, I'm not as young as some of you, so these babies didn't exist. Get home, all the doors are locked. No mom, no dad, no sister. I go downstairs to my best friend's house, Wayne. Wayne's not there. Auntie Pam, his mom's not there. Uncle Wally, his father's not there. But I know they will be at the school, our school, Parkside Primary School. So I'm now at 10 or 11 years old. I walk an extra 2 kilometers to Parkside Primary School. And I finally get to the school, and I'm looking for Auntie Pam. And there across the field, I see Auntie Pam. She comes running towards me. And if anybody calls me this after this speech, I'm going to punch you. But she's, "Polly, Polly, Polly." I'm not Polly, okay? "Where were you, my boy?" I was at the tennis club. She says, "We've been looking for you." I said, "Why? What happened?" "I can't find my mom." "Your mom's been in a terrible car accident." The next time I saw my mom, I was taken to the hospital. She was lying in the ICU room of a hospital. She had tubes inside her lungs. I couldn't go in to talk to my mom. She was lying there at death's door. When I left my mom that morning, she was okay. She was healthy. She was walking. But the next time I saw her, she was nearly dying. And this created anxiety for me from that age. People think, "Why is he so upset? I'm only 2 minutes late. I'm only 5 minutes late. I'm only 10 minutes late. So what?" But if you're late, I think you're dead. Really. That's why when people are late, 1 minute late, I send them a message. "Hey, where are you? You're coming." That's why maybe if you're 5 minutes late, I actually call you. I say, "Hey, are you coming?" Because before mobile phones, I had no idea if people were alive or dead because of that one defining experience in my life. And I remember standing at that window, looking at my mom at death's door, and asking myself a simple question. What is life about? It's difficult when you just stand high and this woman who's your whole life, because my mom was my whole life, is nearly dead. And I realized in that moment that life is fragile. Life is very fragile. Life is short. And time is valuable. So if time is valuable, we should value other people's time to value them. And when we value time, we value people. So please, don't be late. That's not the best.